Town is on tonight. Rideshare companies Uber and Lyft say they will leave Minneapolis on May 1st if a new ordinance passed by the city council takes effect. That ordinance gives a mandated pay boost to drivers, something Uber and Lyft say would cost riders too much money and isn't sustainable.
But as Heidi Wigdahl explains, several other companies are now making sure they're ready to get you where you need to go. Heidi?
Randy and Julie, I spoke to the CEOs of two companies who say they're ready to come to Minneapolis. One of those companies, Empower, says since last week's announcement of Uber and Lyft's plan to leave, they've already seen a couple hundred drivers sign up in case it comes here. And if Uber and Lyft follow through with their plans, Empower anticipates thousands of drivers. A possible Uber-Lyft exit has companies like Rides excited.
It's just kind of grown and take off.
Founder and CEO Steve Wright says they can be found in 20 regions across the country. But they started in Austin, Texas, where Uber and Lyft in 2016 left under different circumstances, only to return a year later.
10 companies came in, very quickly filled the void, and I don't know that the city of Austin really felt that much of a difference. Now, of course, when the big companies came back in, they just started knocking off the mom and pops.
With Rides, drivers pay a monthly subscription of about $100, then keep 100% of the fare.
Is it doable for you to be up and running here by May 1st?
100% from our side, we could be ready. If we got the approval that we need from the city and from the state level, we could be in there in a matter of 2 weeks starting to onboard drivers.
But he says it's going to take a few companies to fill the void, like Empower.
You know, in D.C., almost 250,000 riders have used the platform.
Founder and CEO Joshua Sears says their main market is in the D.C. metro area, providing about 60,000 rides each week. But Empower has hit some bumps in the road. In December, D.C. issued a cease and desist letter saying Empower was not authorized to operate in the district.
We're not a regulatory body. You know, we sell software just like OpenTable sells software to restaurants.
Sears says they only provide the technology. Drivers work for themselves and keep 100% of the fare.
You know, I think there's a lot of things that we can do and tools that we will provide to drivers that will help facilitate any regulatory body's ability to oversee and regulate those individual drivers.
Now, I spoke with the city about this, and they say Empower will need to be licensed in Minneapolis to operate there. The city says so far no new company has submitted an application for a transportation network company license. Once the city receives an application, it takes 2 to 6 weeks for approval. Both companies told me they've reached out to city council members but are still waiting to hear back. Randy.
All right, Heidi, thank you.